All right, here's the puzzle. How the heck does a fantasy sports stock turn into one of the best performing stocks in the market right now at a time when sports are canceled? 3 weeks ago, DraftKings came public via a very complicated triple merger transaction that turned the company into a digital gaming powerhouse. Stock ran up into the deal, and it's run even harder since the closing. Wow, a company, it combined with, it started at what, about 12 bucks at the end of March, and now it's at 29. That includes, of course, the huge run from today, 4 points. So what is driving this one? Okay, the new DraftKings just reported its first quarter as a public company, and the results were pretty solid. Decent revenue beat, small earnings miss, but even though most sports shut down in early March, management's confident commentary sent the stock surging. They're confident because DraftKings is no longer just a daily fantasy sports platform. No, no, with a digital sports betting ticker, it's much bigger than that. It's become a full-blown online casino. It's the only U.S.-focused pure play on online gambling. The lack of sports obviously hurt them, but all the casino closures help. Plus, some sports are finally coming back. Hey, starting with NASCAR on Sunday, and the rest may not be far behind if we're lucky enough to get an early vaccine. Or if they figure out how to play contactless. All right, can this stock keep climbing? Let's take a closer look with Jason Robins. He's the co-founder, chairman, and CEO of DraftKings to get a better read on the quarter and his company's prospects. Mr. Robins, congratulations and welcome back to Mad Money.
Thanks. Good to see you, Jim.
Jason, I'm proud of you. And I saw you right at the Super Bowl, and I was so glad about the things that are happening. You're one of the good guys. But I have to admit, at that point, we were still thinking there'd be a lot of pro sports. If you were to tell me there were no pro sports, I would have said you would have lost a fortune and you'd have no revenues. But you're an inventive guy. Tell people what you did, because the sales were quite good.
Well, hard to believe. You're right. It was only 3 months ago we saw each other. It feels like a lot longer at this point. You know, it's been interesting watching the team pivot to just creating content. And you know, I think also, as you noted, we're starting to see sports come back. The UFC matchup was the first fight, especially, was absolutely huge. Really, really great day for us. NASCAR, as you mentioned, this weekend, the match is coming up where, you know, in addition to Tiger Phil, they have Peyton and Brady this year. And I think that'll be really good. We had really strong numbers on the NFL draft. And then people are playing things like esports and table tennis. We actually just added live streaming for table tennis so people can watch it now. While they're betting on it.
Well, let me ask Jason. I mean, Kyle Busch favored this weekend at Darlington, okay? But there's these guys, Sorensen, Timmy Hall. They're 2,000-to-1 shots. I mean, do people just say, you know what? I'm going to put five on it. I mean, you get those kinds of gamblers?
You know, some people like to take the long shots. Other people, their preference is to create big parlays. So they take, you know, maybe less long shots, but count on being right on making 6, 7, 8 picks correctly. So we've seen people, you know, approach it both ways. But there's definitely an audience that love to throw a few bucks in and see if they can make, you know, thousands or more.
My friends who know esports know that there's fascination and great gambling, and that it's actually a sport that engenders a lot of transactions. Are you seeing that?
Well, esports was really small for us until, you know, about 2 months ago. You know, really, it was the only thing for a little while that people were still playing. And, you know, some sports have started to come back, but esports is stuck. It's been a huge growth area over the last couple months for us. And hard to say what it'll look like once, you know, the traditional sports are back. But I think a lot of people are finding it fun. And, you know, it's also a matter of just getting people to try something new. And, you know, it's interesting. We thought about, you know, how do we engage customers? And esports was something where we knew we had a great product. And if people just tried it, that they would like it. There was, you know, really good integration in a lot of cases with streaming and other things there. And, you know, it's a really solid product, I think, on the fantasy app. So we were pretty excited to see that one grow. And we've also been running these Madden simulations through a relationship with EA Sports, where basically people can go and play fantasy games. And the game is actually simulated NFL games using the Madden technology that EA Sports has. And that's been a really popular one. Table tennis is really taken off. That's a sport that works contactless. So that didn't really slow down too much. And, you know, we're starting to see other things come back. Korean baseball has actually been really popular for us. And I think what it shows you is there's a lot of pent-up demand for sports. People are hungry for sports to come back. They're sitting at home. they want sports, and hopefully we'll see some of our favorites, you know, come back soon enough.
You know, I was watching the ESPN site on draft day and day before, I said, oh, my God, there's just endless articles about who's going to get drafted first. And then I realized, I bet you it was prompted by DraftKings. I mean, you wanted knowledge so that you could bet on the DraftKings site.
Well, I think the draft this year was, same thing. It was kind of one of the only things going on. And we saw a huge growth in draft betting and, engagement year over year in terms of number of bettors. And I think that, a lot of it was centered around who's going to go, first for a particular team. So a lot of people were probably betting their favorite teams and who they were going to pick first. There was a lot of betting on QBs this year. This great QB draft class. So a lot of people betting on which I think everybody kind of knew Burrow would go first. We didn't seem like we could give him short enough odds to get people to stop betting on him as the number one pick. So that was one that just everybody kind of went for. But once it got past him, it was interesting. And a lot of people had Tua, but then others, were betting on a variety of different. And there was also some crazy long shot bets. There was somebody who bet, like $350, I think it was, on Chase Young going to the 49ers. But it was this massive long shot. They would have made like over $100,000 if it hit. So it was pretty interesting to look at the variety of things people were betting on.
Well, you are too much fun. I have to ask one other question. You know that our friend Portnoy affiliated with Penn Nat. You like being independent?
I got to admit, I am a fan of Penn. They're a big partner of ours, and Barstool is great. We know them quite well. Portnoy is hilarious. So, I think they'll do great things together. And it's been funny watching it. I'm sure you've been watching his day trading things.
Of course,
hope it's not real.
I got to believe it's not real.
I think some people, I don't know. I mean, some of my friends have told me, is that real? And I'm like, I'm not 100% sure with him, but I think it's
he's
not
turning it over. Like, he's got these 400,000 to one bets he's making. But anyway, look, I want to wish you the best of luck. You're one of the good guys. We stay with you all the time. And I just think you're having fun. And that's something that I don't see a lot of business people having right now. That is Jason Robins. He's chairman and CEO of DraftKings. The symbol's DKNG. You can see why the stock went up. He's fascinating, and it's fascinating, but he's a businessman. Mad Money's back after the break.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.